गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णु गुरुर्देव महेश्वर गुरु साक्षात् परम ब्रह्म तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। नीलारविंदसुहृदा सदृशं प्रसादे तुल्यं तथा महसितो यजबांधने वेना ब्राह्म्यां स्थितौ तु पितरं वटमूलवासं संस्मारयन्तं अचलन्तमनु स्मरामः। वी आर इन द 12th shloka, and here we read it, no, not 11th. Shastram shraddhavato hanyat saṁśayam napi paryayam shraddhaya kinchidunatve punarabhyudayastayoho. He said, the scripture dispels the doubt and misunderstanding of one who has faith. When the faith weakens a little, they both disappear. This is our lot. Aya Ram, Gaya Ram. We come to Vedanta, yeah, the truth is formless, attributeless. We come to Dvaita, aray, Bhagwan is there, yaar. And then when we come to our seat of meditation, which one should I focus? Formless should I focus, or with form should I focus? कहाँ से आ गई ये contradictions? This is how we are. This is how our mind is. So we have to cut the base. You know, in my driveway there are a lot of weeds, and I enjoy pulling the, I not enjoy, but I every 2 days, 3 days, if I'm walking down, up, down, every time I go, I'll pluck some weeds, Narayan karke ek nikal lene ka, but I make sure that it comes out with the root. Many times I am successful, many times I am not. But when it has not come out of the root, with the root, and even some parts of the root have left behind, 1 month later, again you have got a weed growing in the same place. Same is the condition of these. The nature of these doubts, misunderstandings, contradictions. Just like if we don't chant Hanuman Chalisa regularly, after some days, if you don't chant it for 2-3 months and you come back to Hanuman Chalisa, you'll forget some verses. If you are chanting Rudram, don't chant it for 1 year. If you have been chanting it from childhood, you will, some places you will forget the ups and downs where you have to do that, and some words also you may forget. If you are used to writing, nowadays we are all typing, and then we want to write. Now write a letter, write some notes, take a notebook and start writing. हैंडराइटिंग पता नहीं कहाँ की कहाँ चली जाती है, इट्स नेवर द सेम. वाई? यू हैव टू बी विद इट ऑल द टाइम, यू हैव टू एंगेज विद इट ऑल द टाइम. एंड हाउ डू यू इम्प्रूव व्हेन यू वर बॉर्न? यू वर नॉट बॉर्न राइटिंग. सो हाउ डिड यू मेक योर हैंड राइटिंग सो ब्यूटिफुल ओनली टू लूज इट आफ्टरवर्ड्स? बिकॉज यू बिलीव दैट यू कैन डू इट बेटर. Your parents told you, your teacher told you that have confidence, you can, and you did. But now come to this age where there is no need of writing anything, only punching. Now the habit of, because you are not engaged with it, there is it called atrophy? So same thing is with the scriptures. Remember I told you, we have faith in whom? Faith in God, faith in Guru, faith in scriptures, and faith in our own ability. That yes, I can understand everything in the right manner and come to realize. In Bhagwan there are so many gods, lot of confusion possible. In gurus, so many gurus, which one to follow? Dvaita, Advaita, Vidishta Advaita, Baudha, Vaisheshika, scientists, professors of philosophy, whom do you follow? O Brahmanishta, Kshotriya Brahmanishta Guru. That is also by faith only. Remember, yes, day before yesterday, in Wednesday class, I told the story of Udiya Baba. His own disciple cut his head up. So he was there with the guru with what? With only faith. And little teeny meeny jealousy because someone else came and took the leg to pray, to massage. Where did the faith go? From one moment to the next, and got replaced by anger and revenge. Instead of removing that jealousy, he said the cause of all this is the Guru Maharaj. So Guru Maharaj ko nikal do bahar. See, so same is with our doubt and misunderstandings and contradiction. Until unless we are not, as long as we are engaged with the scriptures, something or the other will keep popping up if we are not subjective. But the question remains, for whom are these doubts, misunderstandings, contradictions? Are they for the God? No. Are these doubts and contradictions and misunderstandings for the Guru? No. Are these doubts, etc., for the scriptures? No. Then for whom? For whom? Is it for the senses? Is it for the world? No. Is it for the senses? No. Is it for the mind? No. Because remember, mind also allows the thoughts to come and allows the thoughts to go. It is not attached to anything. Then for whom are these doubts and contradictions? You must have guessed the answer. The ego. And we have to find where this ego is. What is this ego? And once we have come to know that this ego does not exist, only the self exists. When I say I am, it does not mean I am the ego, I am the self. And what is the poise, what is the disposition of being the self? That can only be known by experiencing it, by being it. By knowing it subjectively as I. Then alone, once the ego has the the doer and the enjoyer, the crystallized consciousness as the ego, which is appearing in its own absence, that ego, that which is not but appearing to be mithyaprate, that ego, when that melts as a result of nididhyasana, then and then alone the doubts, misunderstandings, contradictions are removed from their root. Root is the ego. You understand? In the self there are no doubts, no misunderstandings. Then only they can be completely, forever, once and for all, eradicated, removed, annihilated, dissolved, whatever way word you may call it, strong or soft, whichever, doesn't matter. For that we have to recognize our true identity. Without the recognition of our true identity, doubts will continue to persist. Viparyaya will continue to persist. Now there is a doubt taken, and it says, is stationing, keeping one's own true form, is not different from the vision of the self? Is not keeping the mind in one's own true form, mind focused on the self, is it not different from the vision of the self? In other words, is, because mind is desire, is the desiring of the mind to be the self, to be not other than the self, to know the self, is it not different from the vision of the self? This is the question. Bhagwan answers. See, when we say, when we have a desire to see, then vision is the result of it. If I have a desire for water, then the result is I'll pick up the water and so. So is the desire for the self equal to the vision of the self, or is it different from vision of the self? Because mind is desiring. Mind is desiring. And we have, if we have not inquired properly, if our subjective approach is not correct, then what will happen? We'll forget that mind is nothing but pure consciousness in essence. So who's desiring? Who is desiring? Can pure consciousness desire? No. But mind is nothing but pure consciousness, the self. Then who is desiring? The self with limitations, self with conditionings, is desiring. What? It's desiring the self without conditionings and limitations. है ना, ड्रामा देखो कितना है. बट दिस हैज टू बी सब्जेक्टिवली. दिस इज वॉट हैपन्स ऑन द सीट ऑफ मेडिटेशन. दिस इज नॉट एन इंटेलेक्चुअल एक्सरसाइज हियर. बी अवेयर ऑफ वॉट इज बींग कम्युनिकेटेड टू यू राइट नाउ. सो इफ कॉन्शियसनेस इज वन विद प्योर कॉन्शियसनेस इज ऑल दैट देयर इज, then that is like the conditioned water called wave is desiring to be the water, infinite waters. The conditioned pure consciousness is called the individual consciousness, the mind. It is desiring to be, to know, to merge, to gain, to be at one ment with the infinite consciousness. So, will there be a vision of the self? So, is this desire lead to desire to know the self? Will it lead to the vision of the self? We are so programmed watching these movies and Amar Chitra Katha and all that, where the vision, the moment you are meditating, suddenly the Ramchandra ji comes or Narayana comes or Garuda the Narayana comes or some Bhagawan will come and give you darshan, you have got the vision, you know. So we are so used to that, we have pro we don't realize it, but we have been programmed that way. Nothing wrong. But here the it is not some god. It is not about some god. Can the eyes, can the vision, the faculty of the eyes is vision. Can the vision have the vision of the eyes? Question yourself. Can the vision, the principle of vision in your eyes, can it have the vision of the source, the eyes? The origin of the vision, the eyes, the eyeballs, the pupil. It can illuminate it can illuminate everything in this world, seen or unseen, imagine also. But can it illuminate its source? So the mind, the conditioned consciousness, is desiring the unconditioned consciousness. This is the question. Can it have the vision of the self? If we keep saying that it can it have the vision of the self, the object, the approach is still objective in nature because the mind wants a result, mind wants a vision, mind wants an experience. If you think that you can think of sleep and go to sleep and while sleeping come to know that you are sleeping, is it possible? Can you have the vision of sleep? No. So now this was the question presented to the doubt was brought about that only when the result is given or the result happens, then the bondages, then the doubts are cut completely. But that is not so. Our Bhagwan says that when the desire to see, when the desire to know, when the desire to be is born within the bosom, at that very moment, immediately, the vision of the self takes place and there is no obstruction. It is not that after the abidance, It is not that after the abidance, after being the self, all doubts will be removed. It's immediate. Achirat, without any lag. So if truly the approach is not objective but subjective, and genuinely you have come to the threshold and the final, the desire appears, suppose it is even for sleep or it is for samadhi. Is it that after going to samadhi the cobwebs of the mind are settled down? Can, when you are in samadhi, do you know all the doubts and obstacles that appeared along the way? Do you know? When you are sleeping, do you know the pain of the body and the disturbances, all the different things that you have to do or not done in life? That you have a heart problem or a kidney problem or a leg problem, do you know in sleep? No. So is it that after sleep the problems go away, or the moment you think exclusively of the sleep, that very moment the sleep happens and that very moment all the problems go away, which were stopped, all the desire for the sleep also goes away, isn't it? All the doubts, all the distractions also go away. This is our experience every night. So is true with regards to the self also. These are not two events. Desiring the truth and having the vision of the truth are not two events. If we truly desire, there and then immediate vision, meaning abidance in the self, happens, and at that very moment all the doubts are removed once and for all. And thus one comes to his real form. And what is this form? That form which is without any conditionings, without any limitations, and yet supporting all the conditionings and all the limitations and all the forms. That is your true identity. Transcendental yet immanent. That is your true identity. And in this way, so when we say that we desire to see the self and the resultant abidance in the self, when I say that these two are not two separate events, why they are not two separate events? As I explained before, within the consciousness both things are happening. The desire is also within the consciousness, and the vision, meaning abidance, is also within the consciousness. Therefore it's a desireless desire, it's a visionless vision. Now you will get lost in the words, again contradictions. The material that has gone, see, until this will remain a point of contention as long as our approach is objective in nature. And approach is objective in nature as long as I consider I am the body. you will consider you are the body as long as you think you are the mind. So my mind versus your mind, and that's why the in the beginning I was telling you about the space, about the gold, about the that space inside and outside is essentially one. There are no differences in the space from space point of view. Similarly, from pure consciousness point of view, there is no difference between consciousness and matter. From sun's point of view, there is no difference between day and night. Why there is no difference? Because from his point of view, there is no day and night. Similarly, from pure consciousness, from the reality point of view, there is no consciousness and matter. There is no totality and individuality. Because the pure consciousness is all that there is. So now we are thinking in the relative about how it is from the infinite viewpoint. Again, we bring that infinite into the conditioned consciousness, which is our mind, and we want to think from the mind how the infinite thinks. Infinite doesn't think, it is. What is the difference between even totality and individuality? Individuality has a mind, therefore it is called an individual. Total, he has got no mind, no desires. Individual has desires. He is enslaved by the Prakriti. Ishwara knows Prakriti is his part and parcel, it is his potentiality, and therefore he has no desire for the Prakriti. And we have desire for the Prakriti, so something called mind has come up, and that mind keeps us entangled in the Prakriti. See? So the desire to see and the vision, the difference between them is non-existing. It's one and the same from Bhagwan's point of view. So where are the root, where are the contradictions, where are the... Only when we study the scriptures with faith, wherever there is faith, initially the faith is blind. We have to start that way. Nobody has experienced God. Nobody has... Even though you are the self, you don't know you are the self. So only with faith you can approach it. Only with faith we can come to the scriptures and have faith that the scriptures are giving us the correct direction. With faith we can go to the teacher and wish, hope that he is the right one. Mind, where there is mind, faith is mind and intellect. We require faith. When we come to the self, there is no need of faith. Only in objectivity faith is required. People are in relationship, husband and wife relationship, children and parent relationship, it's all based on faith. Society is together only based on faith. We accept the government only on faith. We live with our neighbors peacefully only out of faith. But is this how the master also functions? Is this how the pure consciousness, the reality also functions out of faith? No. Faith is required where there is objectivity. When we come to the unifying principle that we already are, be that, let mind have faith, let mind study scriptures, let mind have desire for the self, let mind do shravana manana nididhyasana. You be the constant one, you be the unchanging one. So the scriptures, they only teach us the sadhana, the ways, the methodology, the technique to be practiced in the right manner without going astray, what will be helpful to you in order to cross the next barrier, next challenge, next obstacle that we have perceived, we have imagined with our own mind. And when we are practicing these, naturally questions will come. If I'm doing prana, oh, this is Ida, this is Pingala. Achacha, what did you say? Which is Ida, which is Pingala? Oh, what did you say? The four faiths, Swamiji, we forgot. You said in the God, in the teacher, in the self, and what, and what, and what? Scriptures, four. All doubt will come, confusion will be there, because objective approach. You're picking up the information from somewhere and trying to make your own. And it exhausts someone, anyone, why someone, anyone. Anyone will get exhausted because so much is there, so much information is there, so much data is there, so much focus is required, so much single-pointedness is required, so much purification is required. Pasine nikal jate hain. So is there a direct method? Yes, come, be the self, let everything go on. 13th verse. No. 12th verse. Did we do the 12th verse? No.
Mulachedastu vasishtha swarupanubhavetayoho स्वरूपे संस्थितितस् ओके सॉरी मूलच्छेदस्तु वासिष्ठ स्वरूपानुभवेतयोः स्वरूपे संस्थितिस्तस्माद् स्वरूपे संस्थितिस्तस्माद् निदिध्यासनमुच्यते निदिध्यासनमुच्यते मूलच्छेदस्तु वासिष्ठ स्वरूपानुभवेतयोः स्वरूपे संस्थिति तस्मात् निदिध्यासनमुच्यते ओ वसिष्ठ इट इज ओनली बाय एक्सपीरियंस ऑफ बीइंग दैट दे आर बोथ इरेडिकेटेड वंस एंड फॉर ऑल हेंस फर्म अबाइडेंस इन बीइंग इज टर्म्ड एज निदिध्यासना सो आई वाज ऑलरेडी एक्सप्लेनिंग टू यू ऑल दिस. I thought I was on 12th, but apparently I was not on the, I had not chanted the verse. So, only by experience of being, only by abidance in the pure self, only by being. Being is knowing, knowing is being. We have created the difference. Being is something transcendental, existence. We have created the difference, existence, consciousness, bliss. They are not three, they are one. And that you are, in a sense. So do you need to experience yourself, or do you know that you are alive at this moment? That there is conscious life throbbing you through this, through your body, through your mind? Do you need to think that you are, or you are in spite of thinking? If you are answering to yourself that I am in spite of thinking, I don't need thoughts to be, then knowing and being is one. Existence and consciousness is one. The more you remain there in that disposition, in that poise,
alert that, from Google password required.
To that extent, Ananda will express, because the result is Ananda. When I become aware of myself without a thought, the result is ananda. And it is not the result like, if I eat food, then I'll get satisfied. It is not like that. It is spontaneous. Just as spontaneous, as immediate as being the self, on one hand, is the eradication of doubts and misunderstanding on the other. Dukkha nivritti, sukha prapti. They are not, it is not happening in a linear manner. It is instantaneous. The moment sukha prapti, abidance in the self, that very moment, all disturbances, all doubts, all samshaya, all viparaya are cut from their roots, lock, stock and barrel. Nothing to distract you thereafter. Nididhyasana. This is Nididhyasana. And if we are going into samadhi and coming out, then there is still some work to be done. There is still work to be done. Because when you come out of samadhi, you think you had, you enjoyed the peace and bliss, I was one with myself. But when you come out and the world is still there, that means you are not. The ego was not destroyed completely. All that happened with the ego was, ego became the witness, that's all. Identity between the between the Atman, the self, and the infinite Brahman, that has not taken place yet. You have not, the vision has not happened that this self alone is all that there is, without a thought. This hasn't come about. That's why samadhi is happening, you are coming out, again the world is there, again you are going. So that is the traditional way they say Nididhyasana. But true Nididhyasana, as Ramana Maharishi says, is where, and what is your doubt about? Your doubt is about Jeev Jagat Ishwar. Your doubt is about the relationship between the three. The doubt is about what sadhana to be pursued in order to go beyond these three, or see the see that the one consciousness alone is expressing as these three. That is the doubt. The doubt is how that one is appearing as many. The manyness idea is there only because the mind is there. Mind, or I should say, the ego is there. See? Continuing to the 13th verse. Bahis sancharatastata, bahis sancharatastata, swarupe sansthitim vina, swarupe sansthitim vina. अपरोक्षो भवेद् बोधो, अपरोक्षो भवेद् बोधो, न शास्त्रशत चर्चया, स्पेलिंग इज रॉन्ग, शत चर्चया, न शास्त्रशत चर्चया, टुगेदर, बहिः संचरतस्तात् स्वरूपे संस्थितिं विना अपरोक्षो भवेद् बोधो न शास्त्रशत चर्चया. He says, when the mind, when one's mind wanders outside, my child, तात, without firm abidance in being, even the study of hundreds of scriptures cannot confer direct immediate knowledge. If mind wanders outside without firm abidance in the being, until and unless the entire desires in the mind are not completely uprooted which is possible only in abidance. If we are elated by the idea of going into samadhi, into meditation, then meditation ka chaska lag gaya hai. Because after meditation, as I told you before, the world is still there, the challenges are still there, the duality is still there, the obstacles are still there, the hunger is still there. Today one girl in the house, she said, she used some particular word just in the break. She has to go to work and she said, "Oh, I am fed up of all this." 1:30 she has to go to work. I said, "What happened? Is this what life is? Work?" I said, "You are only 23 and 24, 24. At this age you are saying that I am fed up of life. It will lead to depression. At your age, you should be full of life. You should be looking forward to what life has got in store. You should be exploratory. You should be curious about so many things. But by nature, that person is lazy. So that laziness now is translating as disinterest in life. It is not vairagya. It is shirking away from responsibility, is shirking away from what needs to be done. I said, "You got 20, 30, 40, 50, 60 years in front of you. And now at age 23, 24, you are saying, I'm frustrated with life." It's just because the way she said it, and she has said it few times before. That is not the attitude that we want. So to come into the right atmosphere, then what to do? Get up in the morning, take first thing, if you are lazy, get away straight under the shower. Afterwards brush your teeth, afterwards go to toilet. Live a disciplined life. Live a disciplined life. So here, when the mind wanders outside, when will it wander outside? When it will become objective in its pursuit? When it will look for answers outside? When it will start, in very simple words, when will it start thinking about possible options, answers? Only when it is not firmly abiding in its source. And Bhagwan Ramana Maharshi says, thousands of scriptures, and yes, truly, we have thousands and thousands of scriptures, even after that Mohammad Ghori came and burnt away so many universities, still we have enough to last your lifetime at least, and many more lifetimes. But still, it will not bestow upon you the state of liberation, or state, it will not bestow the abidance in the pure consciousness if the study of scriptures is not approached subjectively. This is the point Bhagwan Ramana Maharshi is saying again and again. Jnaneshwar Maharaj is saying again and again, be subjective, they keep repeating it. It's not that because they want to trouble you. Because they must have gone through this, they must have faced this difficulty themselves. Arun Maharshi must have gone through this challenge by him in his own journey. And therefore these wise words. The last verse, 14th verse. See, for for turning away from the mind, we don't have to stop the mind. Like my eyes are open at the moment, they are looking at you, and I can, they are looking at this room and everything. But there are many times when while I'm speaking, I'm so introvert, I'm watching what is going on. At that time, you see that I'm looking at you, but I'm not looking at anyone. I'm not even looking at myself. I'm looking at my mind. I'm looking at the expression of the thoughts as words. What is the source from where this is all coming up? Where is this energy coming from? Where is this breath coming? Wherever the attention goes, my attention question is, what is the source? Soham, 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 soham. So what we call as enlightenment, awakening, nirvana, liberation, jivan mukti, merely studying the scriptures will not bring it about unless and until we are subjective. Until and unless, while studying, our attention is not on the source. स्वरूप संस्थिति स्यात् चेत् स्वरूप संस्थिति स्यात् चेत् सहजा कुंडी नर्षभा सहजा कुंडी नर्षभा सा मुक्ति सा परा निष्ठा सा मुक्ति सा परा निष्ठा स साक्षात्कार ईरितः स साक्षात्कार ईरितः टुगेदर स्वरूप संस्थिति स्यात् चेत् सहजा कुंडी नर्षभा सा मुक्ति सा परा निष्ठा स साक्षात्कार ईरितः ओ ग्रेट कौंडिन्य येट अनदर नेम फॉर हिज डिसाइपल ओ ग्रेट कौंडिन्य If firm abidance in being becomes natural and effortless, beautiful. When firm abidance in the being, in the self, in the infinite becomes firm and natural without any efforts, are wah. Frustration only comes when you think of sleep and sleep doesn't come. But you don't invoke the sleep. Sleep automatically comes. You go to sleep, thinking of sleep, and you glide into it. Natural. Aha. Everything is going normal. Same way. Naturally, we have lived our 24 hours with such awareness that even for a moment, it only requires one spark. That naturally the pull from within comes for the mind to be introverted rather than extroverted. And it seeks the source. It abides in the source. Pratibodha viditam matam. Mind means every thought. Thought is coming and going. But what is the thought about? Is the thought about the world or is the thought about the self? Who am I? What is my source? Where am I? What am I? Where am I? And if with every eruption of thought in our mind, if we can effortlessly, without any process, remain as the substratum rather than remain as the thoughts, remain as the desires, remain as the conditioned one, we recognize effortlessly that we are the one who alone is all that there is. Penultimate step, with every thought we land in ourselves as ourselves, we land in the being. If firm abidance in being becomes natural and effortless, this indeed is final freedom and the supreme state, and is called direct realization. See, many people practice this nirvikalpa samadhi. It is good, one must try also, and one must go in that direction, but one must not get addicted to nirvikalpa samadhi as the final abode. Practice nirvikalpa samadhi, no problem. You are not going to sit in nirvikalpa samadhi for 24 hours. If it is happening, avoid. Don't force yourself to go into it. It will lead to frustration. It will lead to extrovertedness. Because desire. So, as long as naturally you find yourself there, good. What do you do for the rest of the day? You remain aware, live with awareness, contemplate, do the Shravanam Mananam Nididhyasana of how you are that one, and that one alone is the infinite. So that next time when the Nirvikalpa Samadhi happens, it doesn't remain as only Nirvikalpa Samadhi. When the eyes open, you are still in Nirvikalpa Samadhi. Right now, Samadhi means, meditation means, we keep the world at bay and then enter into ourselves, into our source. That is meditation. Sahaja is wherever we are, whether with eyes closed or with eyes open, whether waking, dream or deep sleep, mind will go through its journey. You are always in the self as the self. That is the natural state. Don't even have to think after that. How wonderful will it be? Just thinking about it is so wonderful. Thereafter, no efforts. Thereafter, no inquiry. Thereafter, no differences. Thereafter, everything is self and self alone. Everything is going on. Mind is functioning, senses are functioning, world is going on. All the states are coming and going. But there is no corruption in your being thereafter. Because that being, that natural state, where the identity between the Atman and the Brahman has been realized, the vision of such a master is, I am, full stop. It's not that all this I am. Eyes are seeing, because he is now no longer localized in this body. He is no longer localized in this body. For him, he is the life in every body. Just like in the dream, the mind was the life of every being in the dream. It doesn't stop there. We are imagining this. Master may speak like this, may not, I don't know. And he is also the material which has gone in the whole waking creation. Just like mind is the material with which the entire dream creation is made, so is true here. And all that I am. What will he desire? What will he run away? What will he attachment for? Nothing. He's fulfilled. He's complete. There's nothing lacking in him. Therefore, Swarupa Sansthiti, Swarupa, his essential nature, Sansthiti, abidance, Sahaja, naturally, Kundinar Shabha, oh dear Kaundinya, he who is Sa Mukti Sa Paranishtha, that is the supreme state. That is the supreme abidance, Paranishtha, the supreme abidance. Sa Sakshatkara Irata. That is called as the Atma Sakshatkar. That is called self-realization. That is called direct liberation. That is called true awakening. इति श्री रमण गीतासु ब्रह्म विद्यायां योग शास्त्रे रमणान्ते वासिनो वासिष्ठस्य गणपते रूप निबंधे श्रवण मनन निदिध्यासन निरूपणम नाम पंचदशोध्यायः. Thus, this is the 15th chapter entitled on Shravana Manana Nididhyasana in Sri Ramana Gita, the science of Brahman and the scripture of yoga composed by Ramana's disciple Vasishta Ganapati Muni. Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. हरि ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः. हरि ओम. सिट क्वाइटली फॉर अ मोमेंट. So tomorrow 9 o'clock again we'll begin, but if anyone is interested, there is Bhagavatam at 6:15. You can join in. Aaj sham ko. Hari om.
Hari Om Swamiji, thank you.
Hari Om.
Hari Om Swamiji.
Hari Om Mama,
Hari Om. Hari Om Swamiji, thank you.
Hari Om Baltasar.
Hari Om Swamiji.
Hari Om.
Hari Om Swamiji.
Hari Om.
See you tomorrow.
Ma, see you tomorrow.
Thank you.
Swamiji, Bhagavatam in the same Zoom number?
Yeah, same. Everything is same. I will sign out and I'll come back again at 6:15. Okie dokie.